From JBS Studios in Greater New York, this is the JBS News Update with Teisha Bader.
I'm Teisha Bader with the JBS News Update for Wednesday, August the 14th, 2019. The delegation of Republican members of the U.S. House of Representatives met yesterday with Palestinian leaders. The 31 GOP members, led by House Minority Leader Kevin McCarthy, met with PLO General Secretary Saeb Erekat and Palestinian Authority Prime Minister Mohammed Shtayyeh in Ramallah. Shtayyeh reportedly reiterated to the group the need for a two-state solution and told them that the U.S. is biased towards Israel. PA President Mahmoud Abbas did not attend the meeting, apparently canceling at the last minute. Abbas last week met with 41 Democratic representatives of the House, led by Majority Leader Steny Hoyer. Both delegations were organized by the American Israel Education Foundation, which is an affiliate of pro-Israel lobby AIPAC. Abbas yesterday met with two members of Israel's left-wing Democratic Camp Party, Knesset member Isawi Frege and Noah Rothman, who is the granddaughter of the late former Prime Minister Yitzhak Rabin. The two said they wanted to draw attention to lack of progress towards a peace deal. Rothman criticized Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu for what she said was his inaction and disregard for the Palestinian issue. And for the first time, the Palestinian Authority is under review by the United Nations Committee on the Elimination of Racial Discrimination. Asked yesterday at a meeting in Geneva about anti-Israel prejudice and incitement in media and speeches by Palestinian officials, examples of which were presented by NGOs, non-governmental organizations. PA Foreign Ministry Representative Amar Hijazi denied the claims and said the NGOs wanted to deny Palestinians their rights and narrative. President of NGO Monitor, Professor Gerald Steinberg, who was among the organizations presenting, said the hearing had set a major precedent. Steinberg said Palestinians are being forced to deal with their own anti-Semitism, including in their textbooks. At the second day of the session today, PLO ambassador to the UN in Geneva, Ibrahim Qureshi, brought up the Zionism is racism charge, which was adopted by the UN in 1975. He said that is the root of the problem that we face. Qureshi failed to mention that the UN revoked that resolution in 1991. Police in Brooklyn, New York arrested a suspect who allegedly assaulted two Jewish men Friday night. The 39-year-old man is said to have started arguing with a Jewish man walking in Crown Heights, making anti-Semitic remarks at him and pepper spraying him in the face, also hitting another Jewish man who had tried to intervene with a stick. The suspect was charged with harassment and hate crime assault. Anti-Defamation League New York Regional Director Evan Bernstein called the incident shocking and thanked the NYPD for their quick action. And in California, a Star of David and the word Jude was found carved onto the front door of Temple Mishkan Tefillah in Venice. The LA-based Jewish Journal reported that Rabbi Gabriel Botnick told them that this was the first time such an act occurred at the synagogue, and it was very upsetting to see the neo-Nazi type term. ADL Los Angeles Regional Director Amanda Susskind said the word Jude carved into a synagogue is unequivocally anti-Semitic. The word, which means Jew in German, was painted onto Jewish establishments in Nazi Germany to marginalize, boycott, and terrorize the community. American Jewish Committee Los Angeles Acting Chief of Staff Ganit Abramoff told the Journal there should be zero tolerance for anti-Semitism in our city. Those who attempt to instill fear in our community only make us stronger. Yesterday, by the way, ADL New York, New Jersey Associate Regional Director Richard Prehm joined local community leaders in calling for legislation to educate school children about such hate symbols. 242 American and Canadians received a very warm welcome at Israel's Ben-Gurion Airport this morning, becoming the country's newest Olim, new immigrants. They were part of a special El Al flight chartered by Nefesh B'Nefesh, a nonprofit that eases the Aliyah process from English-speaking countries. This was Nefesh B'Nefesh's 60th charter flight. The new Olim, which includes some 40 young men and women that have committed to join the IDF, were also greeted by a number of Israeli officials, including the Prime Minister's wife, Sarah Netanyahu, Jewish Agency Chair Isaac Herzog, and Absorption Minister Yoav Gallant, who said that Aliyah has been up by 20% over the last year. He said this is a strategic goal of the Israeli government that has contributed to the strengthening of the nation and the Jewish people. Taking a look now at our programming for tonight on JBS for Wednesday, August the 14th at 7 o'clock, French Holocaust survivor Joseph Weissman discusses Jewish persecution in France during World War II and modern-day anti-Semitism in Europe. At 8, lecturer and author Rabbi Joseph Telushkin talks about his book, Rebbe, The Life and Teachings of Menachem Schneerson. At 9, one of the Jewish community's greatest supporters of Israel and Jewish causes, Harvey Kaley, is remembered by his daughter Alicia, grandson Lavi, and friends Rabbi Mark Schneier, Albert Amini, and the CEO of Camp Kaley, David Mandel. At 10:30, filmmaker Ruth Beckerman discusses her biographical drama about former UN Secretary General Kurt Waldheim on Jewish Cinematheque. And coming up right after this newscast, it's Thinking Out Loud with Micah Halpern. And that's the JBS News Update for Wednesday, August the 14th, 2019. I'm Teisha Bader.